This is Boris. Boris is an Eastern carpenter bee and a yearly visitor to my house. He spends a couple weeks in May hovering around my backyard, attacking any other carpenter bees that venture into his territory. What the heck is Boris doing? And what the heck is a carpenter bee? And how can I get rid of carpenter bees without killing them? The second question first. A carpenter bee is a big bee. They're a group of bee species that includes some of the biggest bees out there. And for this reason, they also get confused with those other big bees, bumblebees. Pro tip, you can settle the carpenter bee versus bumblebee debate because carpenter bees have a shiny abdomen, that's a fancy word for their bee bum, whereas bumblebees don't. Also, many species of carpenter bee are all black, the only color being the yellowish-orange pollen that sticks to their legs. Carpenter bees are different from bumblebees and honeybees in that they don't live in large hives with other bees. Like bumblebees, they don't make honey, and carpenter bees pollinate lots of plants, including ones for vegetable farmers and home gardeners like me. Carpenter bees are, well, they're carpenters. They nest in wood. They have very sharp mandibles that can bore through solid wood to create their nests. It works like this. A female carpenter bee, often with 2 to 3 other female carpenter bee friends, will create a nest in a piece of wood. They start by boring against the grain of the wood, and then turn 90 degrees to go with the grain, making a long tunnel. They then go about collecting pollen and nectar. Once they've collected enough, they begin to lay eggs, which are each provisioned with a sphere of bee bread, a doughy mixture of pollen and nectar, which will feed the baby bee once it is hatched into larvae. Once the egg has been given enough bee bread, the tunnel is sealed up and a new egg is laid, and so on until the whole tunnel is filled with larvae happily eating bee bread. Once they've matured into adults, the new bees bore their way out of the tunnel to begin their lives. Interestingly, the larvae all develop into adult bees at the same time, despite being different ages, so they're all ready to bore their way out of the tunnel at the same time. So that's a carpenter bee. So what the heck is Boris doing hovering in my backyard? Well, Boris is defending his territory from other male bees of his species. Males establish territory near the nest entrances of females. Once he mates with the female bees, he will promptly die. Sorry, Boris. I think carpenter bees are super cool, and I don't mind that they live in my shed. Carpenter bees are very unlikely to sting unless handled roughly, think they get trapped in your clothes, and the males don't even have a stinger. They're also great pollinators. However, some people don't really like them, and fair enough. So how can we get rid of carpenter bees without killing them? Well, firstly, carpenter bees don't really like to dig new tunnels because it's a lot of work to chew through all that wood, and they're likely to return to the same tunnel year after year. One thing you can do is just plug up the carpenter bee hole when they emerge in the spring. This will force them to drill another hole, hopefully somewhere else that is more convenient for you. You can also provide them with a sacrificial nesting site. This is kind of like a carpenter bee trap, but a little nicer. An unvarnished and unpainted chunk of raw softwood like cedar or pine in a convenient spot with a little overhang will prove irresistible to any carpenter bee looking for a nest. Once they've nested inside, you can simply move the sacrificial piece of wood to a safe place far away from your home. Finally, how do I protect wood from carpenter bees? Well, making sure that there is no exposed bare wood on your property by painting and varnishing external surfaces or by installing vinyl siding will go a long way towards discouraging these bee friends from setting up shop. Thanks for watching. Check out my Instagram for photos of Boris and his friends and hit subscribe and like if you learned something new. Until next time, don't forget to be yourself.